if anybody. Well, you know, it's all very, isn't it? It's hard to know, isn't it? Because they know where we live. See, there's sort of always an edge to this. I know there's something like could happen afterwards. If the purpose for tonight, the Jewish-Muslim comedy debate, aims to bring together our faiths in a light-hearted manner through the medium of comedy, the goal is to showcase that multiculturalism can work in our vibrant city of Melbourne. Is Mr. Doyle here? He's the high priest.
We're back on the Shtick with Rabbi Daniel Rabin, and you're about to tell us about your training as a counsellor and a psychotherapist.
Yeah, so as I said, a lot of our work is dealing with congregants who may have had, you know, bereavement issues or all sorts of matters that require counselling, and I thought to be better equipped with that, I went on to study, get proper training through a university, and I did my master's in counselling and psychotherapy, which included some very practical units. Most of the lecturers there are trained psychologists and practicing psychologists as well as academics. So often the assignments and all the things you have to do have a very practical feel to them. And I did a 6-month placement in a counselling practice. And the thesis component, which I did, was I called it the never-ending session, which I looked at as a rabbi, you know, and you're experiencing all sorts of things. Are you being impacted upon by the work you're doing? And there's a term called vicarious trauma.
And there's also vicarious joy.
Yes, yeah, so
because you get both ends of
the
spectrum.
You certainly do. And in the thesis, I looked at what happens when you get impacted upon by this work, and it can actually make you feel sad or depressed or feel down. And if the rabbi is not taking care of themselves and self-care and maybe having supervision, they could be affected by what's happening around them. And the vicarious joy, fortunately,
which is all the simchas, because you participate in all these wonderful events,
and
weddings, like bar mitzvahs.
It becomes like your family event, you know. So it was a great study. I looked at various rabbis in the community and looked at things around the world and looked at ways that rabbis can combat the negative parts of this role. Mm. So it was a great thesis. I don't know how I managed to do it with kids and running the shul.
You've got three kids now.
Yeah, kind of.
And it's wonderful to have you coming into the rabbinic council, I think, because one of the functions that you really have to look after is people in the community, especially somebody like Manny Waks. We have to go straight into that now, because Manny's coming back to Melbourne next week, and you're planning
Manny is an incredible guy, and I've had a number of personal dealings with him, and he's a real mensch. And he's done, you know, the benefit that he's given to this community, we'll have infinite amount of, thanks to him.
He broke a lot of ground. I had him on the Shtick before anybody else did. He was the first time he'd been in the media was on the Shtick. We had a whole show with him. And one of the things that I wanted to say was that this week he got a letter from Anton Block, the new president, Mazel Tov Anton, the new president of the Executive Council of Australian Jewry, with an apology. So the event you're going to be, tell us about that.
The event we're going to do, it's Manny's brainchild, and it was his initiative. Mm. And Manny's a visionary, and he thought, he wants to help the Melbourne, the Australian community, the Jewish community, move forward and acknowledge the mistakes that were made, that the leadership, both the religious and the lay leadership, made many mistakes and failed, all these children. And therefore, to move forward, we've got to acknowledge that, we've got to apologize, and at the same time, we've got to plan going forward how we ensure that this doesn't happen again. And so we're having a night of healing, where it will include the lay leadership bodies and the religious bodies coming together. Manny will be a guest speaker at that, and there'll be various others. I might say a few words, and Anton Block, Rabbi Glasman from the National Council, and other speakers. Tzedek will be involved. And I think it's going to be a really important night for the community.
Yes, and we'll keep you informed. It'll be on Facebook. Talking about Facebook, you do a weekly drush, two and a half minutes.
Yeah, I try to keep it under 2.5 minutes if I can.
Yeah, last time we had you on, we told and you're still doing it every week.
Yeah, still doing it. And
you just go bang, action, cameras.
Yeah, look, I take a look at the age or something and see what's news or Facebook, and then I talk about it and how it connects to the parasha.
Yeah, because every week we have a parasha, and every week you can relate the parasha to what's going on in today's world.
The Torah is for infinite amount of time.
Isn't that extraordinary? I love that aspect of Judaism, where you can intertwine, you know, what happened thousands of years ago and the stories in the Torah and what's going on today.
Yeah, and find relevance to today.
Yeah. Totally relevant.
Yeah.
And it's really wonderful to have you on the show.
Thank you.
And I wish you all the best in your role as the president.
Look, it's an exciting role. It's a difficult role, but I hope to set it up that going forward, the next person who takes over will obviously have a good legacy to follow. That's my hope.
And we will also be filming the debate. It's Jewish Community Council of Victoria,
yes,
and the Islamic Council of Victoria having a debate about which is better, the north side or the south side. And we'll be filming that, so looking forward to that. And there's also a whole lot of Purim events still happening, which you're doing.
We got
Purim, a Disney-based one.
Yeah, we've got Purim in Disneyland with all sorts of themed things.
See, this is vicarious joy. When you see everybody enjoying themselves.
Yeah, Purim is certainly amazing.
And until next week, when we have more Shtick, I want to wish you shalom.
Shalom to you, and thank you for the Shtick. It's a great show, and appreciate you having me back on
here. You're doing wonderful work, Dan.
Thank you, my friend.
Thank you. Shalom.
Shalom.
Now, we should put it to you, ladies and gentlemen. We should put it to you. By applause. Is there an applause? Does this thing work? Has that got an applause meter? Now, is anybody... Well, is there a nap? Must be a nap, for God's sake, that tells the truth. Nobody else does. Anybody got an app? There could be money in this, you know. Some kid, a five-year-old. You know, design a nap kid. Not a napkin, a nap kid. We have got an applause meter here, this thing. You see, somebody gave it to me before, but it's already set. Okay? Typical sports, isn't it? And that's without Tommy, isn't it? It says here, draw.